Hey foodies, welcome to Cooking Shooking. Today we are going to make absolutely restaurant style Chatpata Aloo Naan recipe. This is a perfect party snack recipe. Reason why, you can prepare everything and last moment you can just grill and serve. The taste is just like how we get it at the restaurant, so let's get cooking. Let's begin the recipe, guys. First, we are going to quickly make a naan dough for the naans. Here I have a parat or a kneading plate. In this, I am taking 1 cup of maida or plain flour, a little bit of salt as per taste, 1 teaspoon of sugar, about 1/4 teaspoon of baking powder, and half the quantity of baking soda, basically 2 pinches of baking soda. Now we are going to give it a mix, and then we are going to use dahi or yogurt to make the dough. These are instant naans, by the way. We have to make a very soft dough. As you can see, the dough is formed right now. I'm going to take 1 tablespoon of oil and then start kneading it for about 2 to 3 minutes. The dough needs to be super soft and pliable. We will keep this aside for some time. Just cover it with a damp cloth and keep it aside for about 30 minutes. 30 minutes should be fine. In the meanwhile, let's make the aloo tikki. So here I have all the ingredients. By the way, all the ingredients are posted below. Now let's begin cooking. In a kadhai which we have heated in high flame, I'm going to take 2 tablespoons of oil. Once the oil is hot, we can take 1 teaspoon of jeera or cumin seeds. As the jeera sizzles, we are going to add 1/4 cup of peas or mutter. Along with the mutter, I am also going to add about 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste. Now we are going to cook them together for about 1 minute. Be careful, the mutter can splutter right now. After about 1 minute or so, we are going to take 1/4 cup of rice flour. We have to roast the rice flour for about 2 minutes or so. So keep the flame low and continuously stir it for 2 minutes. The version of rice flour that I am using right now is made from Sona Masuri rice. Just grind it up in a mixer grinder. If you don't roast it really well, then your aloo tikki might have a raw taste. Be careful of that. After 2 minutes or so, I am going to add about 3 tablespoons of green chutney. This is the spicy version, guys. I just take some coriander stems, coriander, green chili and a little piece of ginger. Along with water, salt and jeera seeds, I just grind them to a paste and then use it. Once again, we have to cook the rice flour with the chutney for 2 more minutes. This looks great. Now it's time to add the masalas. Here I'm taking salt as per taste, a little bit of amchoor powder for the sour flavor. We are also going to add some garam masala, red chili powder and cumin powder. Now we are going to cook this again for another 2 to 3 minutes. Guys, cooking in each step is very important as it adds a unique flavor. Basically, when we are cooking the masalas, we are taking that bhunawa flavor. So that is achieved right now. I have cooked it for about 3 minutes or so. Now let's add the boiled potatoes to it. Here I am taking 5 potatoes which are boiled, peeled and mashed. We are going to give it a really nice mix and then our aloo masala will be ready. I have turned off the flame and while the aloo cools down, we are going to make the naans. Guys, this is a very involved recipe. You have to be ready for it. You can also make a few things beforehand. Right now what I'm doing is dividing the dough into smaller portions for making the naans. For making the naans, you can make a portion like this, dust it with some dry flour and then roll it into oblong shape like this. Similar to what we do for samosas. So after rolling it, you can see, you can fold it like this and then see it. This is how it will be after cooking it. So now let's heat up a tawa to pre-cook our naans. You don't have to apply any water, any oil, nothing guys. Just heat up a iron tawa or a non-stick tawa and then place it there. In medium flame, we will cook it for about 30 seconds each side. You can also cover this tawa with a lid if you want to. It will be better if you cover it, so I've just cooked it for about 30 seconds. Now I'm going to flip it. We are not looking for any brown spots, golden spots. You just have to get rid of the raw flavor. You can see the half-cooked naan is ready. You can pre-make these a few hours before and then use it. You have to keep it covered, guys. We don't want to lose away the moisture. So I have made 3 or 4 naans right now. Next step, what we are going to do is to make the aloo tikkis. Same step again, we are going to divide the aloo tikkis into smaller portions and then we are going to crumb it. When we make tikkis at home, we usually make bigger ones because that is much more tastier, but for this recipe, you have to make super small tikkis, guys. Trust me, the store ones are even smaller. If you make a too big tikki, then it won't fit inside the naan. So with this recipe, you will be able to make 8 to 10 pieces of chatpata aloo naans. Yes, that's right. Quite a number, but when we are putting so much effort, that has to come out, right? So the next step for this recipe is to make the aloo tikkis. I have divided them into smaller portions. What we are going to do now is take a mixing bowl and then we are going to take same quantity of maida and cornstarch. 1/4 cup of maida and 1/4 cup of cornstarch and a little bit of salt. We are going to mix it really well and then make a batter using water. If you have been watching my videos, then you know if you make a thicker batter, you will get a crunchy tikki. If you make a thinner batter, you will get a crispy tikki. Basic thing, guys, the thicker batter will hold more breadcrumbs. So I have made a thinner type of a batter, flowing consistency, guys. This is perfect. Now what we are going to do is take the aloo tikki and then dip them inside the batter. But before that, we are going to take a large bowl with the breadcrumbs. These are 4mm panko breadcrumbs. What you can also use is fresh bread. Take the bread, place it inside the mixer jar and then grind it. You will get a very nice result. Trust me, guys. I have taken these breadcrumbs in a large bowl because that will help us coat it really well. So the step is to take one aloo tikki, dip it inside the batter, coat it in both sides and then place it in the breadcrumbs and then roll it around, move it around so that we get all the sides covered with the breadcrumbs. So the coating and the crumbing is done. You can see the aloo tikki looks perfect. Similarly, you can pre-make the tikkis like this and the frying and the serving and the assembling process can be done just before you want to serve it. So now this is ready. We are going to cook it. To cook it, I'm going to shallow fry in a pan like this. Medium high flame, guys. We are going to fry them until they are golden. You can also deep fry them if you want to, or even place them inside the oven at 250 degrees centigrade for about 15 minutes. Just preheat the oven before cooking them. As you can see, the tikkis are also ready. Now we are going to make the sauce for the chatpata aloo naan. So here I have a mixing bowl. In this I am taking about 1/2 cup of mayonnaise. This is eggless mayonnaise. If you want to see how to make that at home, you can click the card above. Along with the mayonnaise, I am also going to take 2 tablespoons of red chili sauce. We are going to mix it really well and we are also going to add a little bit of color. Color is added, guys. We can't do anything. We want to have the same look and color and the feel. So I'm adding it. It's totally optional to use color. You can avoid it. We can also use organic colors or even chili oleo resin, but that's very difficult to find everywhere. So the simple thing is to use food color. Our sauce is also ready at home. Now it's time to assemble and serve. So here I have 2 naans. I'm going to place them in the board and then we are going to find the tikki match for them. Basically, just find the tikkis. If it fits like this, it's ready. So keep the tikkis aside for now. We are going to smear a good dollop of the sauce in one side only. Over top of that, we are going to add a handful of sliced onions. Now it's time to place the tikki and then what we are going to do is flip it around so that the naan does not open up while cooking it. See, the last step is so easy. We just fried the tikki and then we are taking the naans, applying the sauce, onions and the tikki, folding it and then cooking it. So for cooking it, what we are going to do is take a griller or a panini maker or a grill toaster, anything that you can find, even a tawa will work right now, guys. So this is a hot panini press. I'm going to add a little bit of butter and then I'm going to place the aloo naan. On top of the aloo naan, I'm also going to place some more butter and then grill it until it is golden. Man, this video is really long, but this looks really worth it right now. You can make everything beforehand, like one day before, make the naans, make the tikki mixture, fry it serving time, assemble it serving time, and then grill it serving time. It's going to be perfect. The aloo naan is ready. I'm going to now take it out and then serve it. It's time to dig in. There's a lot going on for this recipe for sure. The homemade one is the bomb, guys. See the texture, the naan is super soft and the tikki is crunchy and looks so delicious. And the sauce that we made is the magic. You have to try this one. If you recall my Taco Mexicana video, I had said, ye rajma chawali to hai. In this video, what I would say is naan or aloo tikki to hai. Lekin guys, the thing is, this is super delicious, especially the way we have made it and the sauce that we have made is super fresh, which makes it even more delicious than the restaurants that we buy at. So do try it. I'm sure you're going to love this one. If you try it, do click a photo and send it across to me on Instagram at cooking.shooking. See you soon with one more delicious recipe. Until next time, make sure to click the subscribe button and ring the bell icon beside it so that you get notified about my next video. Bye for now. Take care. Happy cooking.